He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Let's work through a problem regarding limiting reagent and percent yield. So the question is, according to the following reaction, if 2.00 grams of silicon and 1.50 grams of nitrogen react, first, which substance is the limiting reagent? Then, what is the theoretical yield of our product in grams? And lastly, if 2.89 grams of product are actually obtained, then what is the percent yield of the reaction? So if this seems overwhelming, go ahead and check out my tutorial on limiting reagents and percent yield. That should clarify a few things, and when you're ready to go, give this problem a shot. So here's our reaction, and here are the masses of the reactants that we're working with. So what do we want to do first? Well, definitely the first thing we want to do is convert these masses into moles, because masses don't tell us anything, because substances all have different molar masses, and reactions occur according to stoichiometry, so they're numerical ratios. So masses don't tell us anything. So let's take our 2.00 grams of silicon, and we're going to multiply by 1 mole over 28.09 grams. That is the molar mass of silicon. So grams are going to cancel, and we're going to get 0.0712 moles of silicon. So now we have the number of moles of silicon. Let's do the same for nitrogen. We're going to take 1.50 grams of nitrogen, and we're going to multiply by 1 mole over 28.01 grams of nitrogen, because we have two nitrogen atoms, each of which weigh about 14 atomic mass units. So times 2, we get 28.01 to be specific, and that is the molar mass of N2, and that way grams cancel, and we end up with 0.0536 moles of N2. So this is going to get us in a much better position to know what is going on. So let's replace our masses with our values in moles. So now we have to figure out which one is the limiting reagent. Now we must be aware that the limiting reagent is not automatically the substance in the lesser amount. It is very common to just look at these and say, well, there's less N2, so that must limit the reaction. But that will not always be the case. If you recall from my limiting reagent tutorial, we had our bologna sandwiches, and even though we had 7 pieces of bologna and 10 pieces of bread, it was actually the bread that limited the reaction, because we could only make 5 sandwiches out of the 10 breads, as opposed to 7 sandwiches with 7 pieces of bologna. So we do have to consult the stoichiometric coefficients here. That is going to be a factor. So there are 2 ways that we can do this. One way that we can do this is to take our 0.0712 moles of silicon, and let's find out how many moles of nitrogen would react with this much silicon according to this reaction. So let's take this and multiply by 2 moles of N2 over 3 moles of Si. Because for every 3 moles of silicon, we need 2 moles of nitrogen. So let's see how much nitrogen we would need. So moles of silicon cancel out, and we get an answer in moles of nitrogen. And it turns out that we would need 0.0475 moles of nitrogen. Now, do we have that much? We do have more than that. We have more nitrogen than we would need to react completely with that amount of silicon. So the fact that we have enough nitrogen for all of the silicon to react means that silicon is the limiting reagent. Just to be thorough, let's go ahead and look at N2. We have our moles of N2. Let's see how much silicon would be needed for all of this nitrogen to react. So we're going to take our value and we're going to multiply by 3 moles of silicon for every 2 moles of N2. Once again, that's according to the stoichiometric coefficients in the balanced equation. Moles of N2 will cancel, and we will get 0.0804 moles of silicon. do we have enough silicon? We do not have that much silicon. We have less than that amount of silicon. So that means that the silicon will run out before all of the nitrogen has a chance to completely react. That means nitrogen will be in excess. So once again, we are saying that regardless of which reactant we're looking at, we're realizing that silicon must be the limiting reagent. Just to be thorough, let's look at this one other way. We can also take each reactant and see how much product we would make. So let's take our moles of silicon and multiply by 1 mole of product for every 3 moles of silicon. Moles of silicon cancel, and we get 0.0237 moles of product. Now let's do the same for the amount of nitrogen that we have. We're going to multiply by 1 over 2 because we have a 1 to 2 ratio with the coefficients. Moles of nitrogen cancel, and we get 0.0268 moles of our product. So the fact that silicon would make less of the product than nitrogen could upon both of those substances reacting completely again tells us that silicon is the limiting reagent. So you can use either strategy. You can see how much of the other reactant would be needed for the first reactant to be used up completely, or you could see how much product each of the quantities of the reactants could form, and whichever one makes less is limiting. So it's totally up to you. These are both valid ways to do it. So as we said, silicon is the limiting reagent, and now we need the theoretical yield. Well, fortunately, using our second method, we've already calculated that, because what the theoretical yield means is it is the maximum amount of product that is physically possible to form if all of the limiting reagent is used up and converted into product. So that involves that calculation that we just did. We take our moles of the limiting reagent and we use the stoichiometric coefficients to get the moles of product that we can expect from that amount of the limiting reagent that we have. So that is our 0.0237 moles of product. And now we just want to convert that into grams so that we have a value in grams. So in order to do that, we need the molar mass of Si3N4. And if we tally up 3 silicon atoms and 4 nitrogen atoms, that adds up to 140.28 grams. So we need to multiply our value in moles by that many grams over 1 mole. And that way, moles will cancel and we will get a value in grams. And to 3 sig figs, that is going to be 3.32 grams. So that is our theoretical yield for this reaction. And lastly, we wanted to know what the percent yield would be if we only got a 2.89 gram actual yield. So remember, percent yield is actual yield over theoretical yield times 100 expressed as a percentage. So we got 2.89 grams, divide by 3.32 grams, which is the maximum that we could possibly get, times 100, that is an 87.0% yield. So that's a little bit of practice in identifying the limiting reagent, calculating the theoretical yield, and the percent yield.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.